everyone. Welcome to the Global Services Sales virtual booth at Extreme Connect. My name is Lynn Frazier, and I'm the Senior Director of Strategy and Planning for Global Services Sales, and I'll be leading a discussion with Rob Rosa, our Senior Vice President of Global Services Sales. And this will be related to how our service offerings enable an effortless experience for both our valued customers and our partners. Now, Rob, our customers and partners will be hearing a lot about the Infinite Enterprise at Extreme Connect. Can you please talk a bit about what this entails and how it will benefit our customers and partners?
Yeah, Lynn, thanks for asking. And everybody, thank you for attending Extreme Connect. We're really excited about the virtual event, and there's a lot of great information being shared, and we look forward to talking to you in the future as well. The Infinite Enterprise, what's happened? Digital transformation. The word, that's kind of been the catchphrase, digital transformation. Well, now Infinite Enterprise is the new wording that we're using. It talks about what's happened with the pandemic. If we step back and think, what's gone on? Well, we've all moved to a remote work environment. Most of us are not going in the office because of the pandemic. Telehealth, online shopping, online grocery shopping. How about just online food ordering for restaurants? All those things have pushed the world to more digital, the digital transformation, and the Infinite Enterprise is behind that. What are the characteristics? Infinitely distributed. You could be anywhere, anytime. It's scalable by the cloud. We hear a lot of folks talking about going to the cloud. Well, what has happened in the cloud environment? A lot of the process work has been moved to the cloud. A lot of the difficult on-prem applications still have not been moved to the cloud, or they're being moved to the cloud as we speak. We've been on a cloud journey for at least 10 years, and there's still a long journey to go. So we want to move to the cloud through the Infinite Enterprise. And then data. Data is the new currency. You can leverage the data through various aspects, whether that's Extreme Cloud IQ, you have different capabilities inside that, but data is king now. You used to hear cash is king, data is king in the technology world. And we're real excited at Extreme about the progression we've made in our cloud application and where we're heading in the future.
That is great, great explanation. So now, if you could just dive a little bit deeper into what we mean by an effortless experience and how services is a key ingredient to make this a reality.
There's really three elements to the Extreme solution. It's the technology, the universal hardware. It's the Extreme XIQ pilot license. And then it's services. So what makes a solution? Not one, not two, but all three of those elements. And from my perspective, services plays a key role in the journey. Now let's talk about the journey. We have customers that are at the beginning of the journey, meaning, hey, I'm just thinking about it. Maybe they've been behind and they're going to get caught up. We have other customers that have already started the journey. They're on their technology lifecycle journey. They could be 2 years in, 3 years in. It doesn't really matter. But at the end of the day, what I tend to find when I talk to customers and partners is they need help from the vendor, from the value-added reseller to talk about, hey, I'm stuck or I'm at this point and I need to get to this point. Where's my journey? So we can create a journey map to take a customer from wherever they are in time right now to get them to the Infinite Enterprise. What does that entail? It could be consulting services, professional services. It could be a managed service. It could be a new consumption model. But we're here to expedite and make it easier for our customers through services to drive that effortless experience.
That is excellent. And it's a great segue for us to dive into our service offerings and what we can specifically deliver to support our customers. Also to mitigate the risk of downtime and ensure that effortless experience you just spoke about. Let's focus today on the maintenance and support offerings. And at the end of this session, we'll point everyone to a great session in our booth, which is centered around Premier and our white glove offering.
Yeah, Lynn, that's great. So obviously foundational services, maintenance, support. Extreme has been recognized multiple times by Gartner as in the peer review as the number one company for services. Why? We take a differentiated approach. Customers may hear that from other vendors, but I'll give you the reasons why. First, from a maintenance support perspective, we are 100% insourced. There is no outsourcing done from Extreme. We believe that is experience and knowledge that stays inside of Extreme and is retained by Extreme. And we have years of experience troubleshooting the network and understanding the customer's topology of their network so we can help troubleshoot. So that's first. Second, the tenure of our team, over 10 to 15 years, average tenure for our engineers. That's just to have that experience and knowledge. We have folks that have been here even longer than that, that have seen the whole evolution of Extreme and the technology. Third, when you call into a support call, you're going to get a level one, level two engineer from Extreme. Extreme employee who's experienced and knowledgeable, and at 75 to 80% of the time will resolve the case and the problem on that first call. If they're not able to do it, we will transfer that to a level three, level four engineer. And if we have to go higher than that, it typically will be pulled into our product line management or our engineer software engineering group to figure out, is it a bug? Is it something else? What can we do? And we bring the people that actually built the application or the product into the conversation to help troubleshoot that problem. It's very different than many other companies. If you call into some other companies, you're going to get an outsourced person reading off of a script. That's going to be a 30-minute phone call first. Hey, what's your name? What's your contract? What's wrong? Is it plugged in? Is it turned on? Is the lights green, red? We're not going to do that to you. We're going to take you through the steps. We're going to get you there quicker. We're going to resolve your problem. In other companies, you could spend six to seven leaps before you get to a highest person who may be able to resolve the problem. But that will be rare, and that will be a lot of time you waste. To me, this is about resolving downtime and this whole experience of uptime, keeping the network running, giving where everybody is working. Uptime is critical, and we can support that through maintenance and support and our world-class team.
Yeah, that is very true, world-class service and support, and we're very proud of it. All right, now let's change gears a little bit. Now that you've covered what we can provide to our customers to ensure a total solution, now let's talk a little bit about how these services can be purchased and consumed.
Yeah, this is probably the fun part of what I get to talk about. We know the world is going crazy about new consumption models. How do we consume? Well, we can provide multiple ways of consuming the technology, and we can do it at the pace that you're ready for. So a traditional leasing agreement, you could lease the equipment, consider it a bank finance agreement, a dollar purchase buyout at the end. Various financial applications to buy the equipment with a payment plan, a loan, or a lease. That's the traditional way. Typically, what you'll hear from most vendors is, hey, why don't you finance it? That's what they're talking about. But Extreme has gone past that point. And we are a leader. We are one of the first technology companies to be doing this. We have network as a service. We have Extreme Network as a service. They're basically consumption models. One is a little bit more elaborate than the other. When I say that, the Extreme Network as a service, that's typically boxes, meaning, hey, I would like to rent boxes, and I will pay you a monthly fee for those boxes. Great. How many do you need? Where do you need them? We will send them to you. We have a simple two-page document that you have to sign up to that actually has cancellation rights, meaning after 60 days, you can cancel. There's no long-term commitment. It is a pure OpEx experience for you from a financial perspective. Network infrastructure as a service is a little bit different. It does the same as Extreme Networks as a service, but it can also include professional services and other managed services that you want to layer in there. So again, think about, hey, maybe I don't want to just rent APs or switches. Maybe I want to buy switching as a service. Maybe I want to buy Wi-Fi as a service. Well, we can develop a consumption model tied to Wi-Fi as a service, bring it out to you as the customer, and propose a per month, a per store, a per whatever you want it to be type price. And you can consume that again in an OpEx fashion, but you can roll in the cost of implementing. So maybe you have a centralized organization and it's a decentralized company and you need resources outside of the central location. It's a great opportunity. And then lastly, in the education space, whether outside the United States or inside the United States, it does not matter. We created this campus agreement. Think of it as an enterprise agreement where we build the model based on a per student price. You pay a price per student. You get your maintenance, you get your support, you get some professional services, you even get software licenses included, and you pay on a per student basis. We want you to consume as much Extreme technology as you can. So during the life of that agreement, you buy new technology. There is no additional maintenance. There's no additional service expense. You will just continue to pay that per student price. The only time it changes is if your student count changes. So if your student count changes year over year, that's the price difference. But otherwise, the price stays the same. We typically do this in a three-year agreement, and we do a true up on an annual basis saying how many students do you have for next year. We give you the price and you're off to the races, assuming and using the Extreme technology and services. It's a great, great solution for the education space, whether higher ed or K through 12. We have a lot of customers taking advantage of this, and it's allowing them to consume the technology even faster.
Again, that is awesome and very flexible. So many different solutions and consumption models. Great, Rob. All right, so to close this out, I just wanted to thank you, Rob, first, and thanks to everyone who is listening currently. We so appreciate it. Please go to our Global Services Sales virtual booth and listen to the other sessions available as well. We have a great Q&A led by Matt Fries, our Americas Services Sales Leader, Bruno Luce, our Renewal Sales Leader, along with Scott Day, who is a Director of Network Services at Baylor University. We also have posted a session with Jan Heinbokel, our Senior Director of International Services Sales, and Simone Walting, International Services Account Executive, who will provide some great information on our premier offering as well. And we do have some other resources that we've posted that we think you'll enjoy. So please stop by virtually to our booth, and thank you again very much.
Thanks, Lynn.